Guys, this is just a very, very quick video about exactly what happened with GME and what is currently happening today with GME. As we see, GME has taken a major, major dip. We had seen a 17% dip the day before, and we're seeing currently a 13% dip as of this morning, Tuesday, March 16th. And this is going to be a too long didn't read, extremely fast overview of why the dip happened due to ETF shares being lent out. And I think you guys should watch to the end and pay attention. So exchange traded funds, right? ETFs. If you guys weren't aware that that's what ETFs stand for, there it is. Demonic Psycho. Thank you so much for the super. I'll check it in a sec. An exchange traded fund is a type of security that tracks an index sector, commodity, or other asset, but can be purchased or sold on a stock exchange the same as a regular stock. An ETF can be structured to track anything from the price of an individual commodity to a large and diverse collection of securities, right? Everyone knows what an ETF is. Now they're on the same page. ETFs can even be structured to track specific investment strategies. You can consider them a hybrid of mutual funds. One of the biggest ETFs is S&P 500, right? Tracks the 500 biggest companies, or perhaps whatever companies they deem to be relevant to being big. And that is why we are trying to spread out our risk by buying a bunch of companies at the same time rather than just one company. Short selling. Now we understand what ETFs are. Let's go to short selling. It is the process of selling shares that you don't own but have instead borrowed, likely from a brokerage. Most people short sell for two reasons. One, they expect the price to decline. Short sellers hope to sell shares at a high price today and use the proceeds to buy back the borrowed shares at a lower price sometime in the future in a bid to profit. That's a very simple one sentence explanation, but if you haven't yet fully grasped a short yet, I focus on that in my very first video on the GME topic months ago. You should check that out in the playlist at the end of this video. Or two, they want to hedge or offset in a position held in another security. For example, if you've sold a put option, an offsetting position would be to short sell the underlying security. Okay, so this is a way to be able to hedge your position. Hedging is the idea that you want to be able to not put all your eggs in one basket, and that's the easiest way to understand that. Authorized participants, an AP. An authorized participant is an organization that has a right to create and redeem shares of an exchange traded fund, right, an ETF. They provide a large portion of the liquidity in the ETF market by obtaining the underlying assets required to create the shares of an ETF. When there is a shortage of ETF shares in the market, authorized participants create more. Likewise, an ETF borrow costs increase. APs are less likely to borrow shares to hedge their position and more likely to fail to deliver, right? We've talked about FTDs before, but it's when you have a share that you've lent out, you borrowed, but you just doesn't exist yet. So you have to find someone to borrow it from after the fact that you've already sold it. That's crazy how our system works, because that is sometimes often very legal. In a typical transaction, the borrower of a stock posts collateral of 102 to 105% of the share's value in cash, government securities, or a bank letter of credit. If the ETF needs to sell the stock, it can recall it from the former. But if the borrower, for any reason, isn't able to deliver the shares, the ETF is repaid through the collateral instead, although that can have adverse tax consequences for the ETF. So, the GME relationship. Let's look at a past trend of an ETF with GME. Now, I'm not claiming today's red day was entirely due to ETFs being shorted or their shares being lent out, but there is significant evidence that leads me to believe that this is one of the key factors. Let's look at this. Rush to the exit. This is data from Bloomberg. Total assets in XRT plummet amid GameStop drama. So this is between February, March, blah, 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 all the way to January. And in January, look at that big plummet. I'm gonna slide this over a little bit more. This is US dollars in the millions. And just note how many assets in XRT plummet, just drop. So now that you've understood that, let us talk about exactly what that means. By law, a fund cannot have any more than 1/3 of its total assets in securities on loan. Few ETFs or other funds ever reach that ceiling, and ETFs are considered to be more conservative lenders than other funds. Market makers are continually creating new ETF shares and redeeming others. So the number of ETF shares outstanding fluctuates. Because the supply isn't fixed, there really is no impact on performance when an ETF is net short, industry participants say. The prices of ETF shares typically stay very close to the value of the underlying holdings. ETF shares borrowed today saw significant lending. Suspicious, isn't it? So 6.5 million available last week to 4 million today, and then 1.5 million available last week to 850,000 today. So we're noticing that a lot of these shorts that are available, these shares that are available, are not available anymore because they are being lent out. Just taking these account, three ETF lendings, you can see 3.5 million shares were borrowed in today's trading session. The short sellers effectively manipulate prices by borrowing shares in a company to sell them with downward pressure, coupling it with high frequency machines being used. The price of security can significantly drop in a rapid succession, as we've witnessed for the past few trading days. He's talking about a short ladder attack. Right. This is just an algorithmic way to be able to push a price down by being able to sell them with downward pressure. And that's why we often use indicators like the VWAP, right? The volume that shows us exactly where we are looking at, more so than we are actually trying to trade with these short attacks. It gives us a little bit more perspective, and that's that orange line in these graphs. The easiest way to understand this is that if the orange line is currently above your price, it's likely that the volume does not support the direction it is going, and you can see that basically all day yesterday. Not enough volume to support the amount of a price drop. Too suspicious here. The hedge funds have most likely synthetically shorted GME via ETFs to drive its price down. Since then, they have also legally disguised their short position via synthetic longs, and there's concrete evidence that they have done this on the various articles posted before. When coupled with synthetic longs via options, gives the appearance of shorts covering when they haven't, takes GME off the threshold security list when it shouldn't be, and provides the ability to naked short GME again. If you guys have not talked about yet synthetic longs or counterfeit shorts, or they're also called naked shorts, I covered those exactly piecemeal, one at a time, in previous videos. This was the missing piece of how GME could actually be shorted without appearing so. This solves the NYSE threshold securities issue and ability to drive GME down outside of buying a put. Ultimately, they have to cover these shorts sometime or another. If the ETFs recall their shares back, that would mean an absolute effery of Melvin and Citadel, given that they are still paying massive short interest without the numbers actually showing up in the threshold index. The link between FTDs and ETFs. ETFs are a growing force in the financial markets and constitute almost 25% of the US equity trading volume. Therefore, please keep in mind that not all shares shorted with a specific ETF is directly linked to GME. All right? Make sure there's a little bit of nuance in your life here. And finally, just to define FTDs a little late in the game, a condition where two investors agree to the purchase sale of a security at a given price, but the seller fails to deliver the security in a timely manner. Basically, it's like Amazon failing to deliver your package in a timely manner. So authorized participant arbitrage option. When faced with excessive buying, right here, pressure we have witnessed from with GME, authorized participants and market may sell shares as naked and then locate or create the shares at a later time. It's to allow for asynchronous market activity. Essentially, I want to sell a share right now, but I just don't have anyone who's a good friend of mine to give me their share so that I can sell it and then give it back to them later. So I'll just imagine that a share exists and sell it to someone even though it doesn't yet, and I'll find that borrower later. Right. The T plus six for bona fide market making. However, delaying past T plus three results in a failure to deliver, but AP, authorized participants, and market makers are allowed to fail past T plus three because they are making markets and have an additional 3 days to settle trades for a total of T plus six. This choice of shorting can also lock in a profit if options are used to hedge their exposure, but with less capital outlay. And that's really important as well. They won't go in too depth about options hedging in this post because I want to keep the topic on the point of ETFs. However, they see a lot of misconception regarding calls and delta hedging, which leads to misinformation being spread. Too long didn't read. Do not worry about the price decreasing. This is all synthetically created to kick down the eventual outcome down the road through lending ETF shares, and recent data proves that. Over 3.5 million shares were lent out through ETFs yesterday, and their failure to deliver are accumulating each and every day. It's exactly like maxing out your credit card with your other credit card, right? Does it solve the issue? No, it just makes it so that you have to pay it off later, but for the moment, it could make it so that everyone loses confidence. That's why we always get scissors in the chat for the kind of paper hands who look at these tricks and immediately balk and get afraid, People who cheer for GME being put on the shortlist need to also realize that there is no significant impact, as hedge funds have other ways of artificially decreasing the price. This flies in the face of how important the SSR list is to Rensel and Pixel, who had part of the SSR being the very first part of his endgame DD. So we need to have Coastal Hot Dog on the show. If you are Coastal Hot Dog, please, I want you to come and talk to Pixel and debate about exactly when the squeeze is actually going to happen. If you guys like this video because of its quick and snappy, exactly to the point of what you need to know, or you wanted to be able to look through more videos, I'm going to focus up and find the videos on my channel that describes each of these concepts, right? Synthetic longs, naked shorts, gamma squeeze, and everything else we mentioned in this video. If you guys wanted to support the show, you can easily do it with one of these, either the join button down below next to the subscribe button, or go on my Patreon, which is how this show is brought to you every single day, live streamed when market opens, and join the Moon Platoon over here, the Space Legend tier over here, or the coveted Gorillionaire tier would be amazingly appreciated by me. For now, but not for forever, hope you have an awesome day.